Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the second day of the John Wick Invitational. Invitational, that's a new word for your dictionaries. You're here with your friendly broadcaster, Avela, and the colorful color commentator, Cadian, as we'll be providing you the coverage of the semifinals and hopefully the finals tomorrow as well here on FACEIT TV. Live from Milan.
Yes.
Denial won the first map of this best of three. Cash, they were able to beat SKDC after a pretty lackluster terrorist side from the Canadian team. But there's Inferno and Mirage left. Mirage, if needed, if SKDC can beat Denial in the next match. Yeah. But what exactly happened with SKDC? I mean, they played a really good CT side due to Wabbit. He got some really, really... I love saying his name. It makes me...
Wabbit.
But cute way of saying rabbit. But he played great. He got them some nice rounds, kept them in the game. They were able to get 9 rounds on the CT side. Great start to the T side, getting 4 rounds. But then all of a sudden, it just broke down.
I think the biggest difference or the biggest reason why SKDC lost that game was probably the throw in the anti-eco on the CT side. Had they been receiving those 2 free rounds, they would be actually having 15 rounds, theoretically. And that would put a lot of more pressure on the terrorists on the new CT side, and therefore they would be able to win it.
Yep.
So that anti-eco throw was, yeah, just extremely important in that sense.
We start off the second map of this best of three with...
he dies without hitting anyone. Ocean.
For a kamikaze. With a knife round here on Inferno. Inferno, historically a CT-sided map.
Yeah. We played it against Fnatic in the Cisco Legend series, as we talked about, and at that game, it was also extremely CT-sided. Both teams had big problems on actually getting to, yeah, just get 3 rounds as a terrorist. It was kind of weird.
Yeah. We'll have a quick break until the beginning of the game after that knife round, so we'll be right back. I think somebody's having a pee.
On the men's room. Say it. Be right back.
All right, so everyone's going to go have a quick pee.
Yeah. So it's going to be 2 minutes before they're going to start. And yeah, even though they're pro gamers, they need to go to the bathroom just as much as any other guy.
Yes. Call of nature. Even pro gamers, they have to answer to it.
Yeah.
So no hate to them there. I know a lot of you want to watch Counter-Strike, but... If you need to go to the toilet, you need to go to the toilet. A man's going to do what a man's
I hate that, though. When you're watching on your PC, you're watching a very tense game, and it's always in the wrong moment you need to go to the bathroom. But that's why you have a smartphone, and you installed the Twitch app. So you can sit in the bathroom with your little phone and watch the game, even though you are not...
Very, very, very hygienic thing to do.
Yeah.
But
very clever.
Yeah, but very clever.
Yeah, you do that as well?
I don't like to take my phone in. I will not openly admit to it in front of thousands of people because it's not a good thing, but I know
guilty.
All of us do it, including probably myself as well. But
guilty.
Yeah, you're guilty. Well, I'm innocent until proven guilty, so nobody's going to prove guilty unless they install a camera in my bathroom, which hopefully will not happen anytime soon.
I think people would be up for it. We could give it a try here in Milan.
Please not.
Please don't.
No,
please don't.
Please don't. I beg
Well,
you.
Anyways, I know that probably the majority of the people do it just because why would you miss a round when you can just sit with your phone and watch it?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, if you're a huge Counter-Strike fan. It depends what kind of... Okay, great conversation about toilets. I was just going to go into more detail, but we don't have to. Really don't have to. But one thing I want to say, it would be frustrating as a player, I guess. I think it's nervousness, really. You know, when you're nervous, you do urinate a bit more. And I think these players are nervous. It's the semi-final. You can win $10,000 if you get first place. So why not get nervous? And for these players, I think it's probably... one of the biggest opportunities that they've had in some of their CSGO careers.
$10,000, man. That's a lot of money. That's
You'd like that $10,000, wouldn't
I would
you?
Like them.
Why don't you become American? Why don't you play for an American team?
Actually, it would be fairly cool to move to America for a year or something. I'm ending school next year, so...
Easy peasy monies.
Call me, boys. Call me.
Cadian on your new NA team.
Yeah.
Mixed team. Mm-hmm. Carry you to the finals.
Exactly.
Yeah.
No anti-cheat. I'm all in.
No anti-cheat. It's definitely something to note. You never know. You never know who's cheating. It's something that's kind of hurt the reputation of Counter-Strike. We've seen some one or two players, you know, cheat in tournaments in the past. But this is the start here of the first round of this second map in the best of three. It is Inferno, Denial versus SKDC, and Denial winning that knife round will be starting off on the stronger side, the CT side, as they do have a two-man stack over towards the B side, with one in support over on Speedway.
Yeah, they have fast rotation coming in from that guy in case they're going to initiate this B push. And Ocean with the smoke for CT. Oh, what? Oh. Yeah, it should be. Would be weird throwing a smoke for cards in this situation unless they're going to charge through CT spawn. But here comes the B push, and the CTs is going to be three guys to counter smoke. And he does push the smoke.
Two big frags there for Shazam. He stops that B push in his track. And a very, very quick rotation coming in from the CTs. So Nitro will be able to take down Slumpy as Denial keeps control of the B site and the bomb as well. Automatically remaining there for SKDC. Well, he gets a frag on Nitro. It makes it a 3-on-1, but it's a very, very tough situation for him to be in. The bomb's down. He's only got a Glock, E1 HP, and he's against three Denial players who are pretty much waiting for him to peek. And waiting for the opportunity to finish off this round. Make it 1-0 for Denial as they win that pistol round with relative ease. That B site push not really working out for them.
Well, what you want to do in a situation like that, when you go for a simple execute with only like one smoke and two flashbangs, you want to spread out on the map in the first minute or so of the round, making the CTs use all of their grenades, and then you can rotate to the final destination and go for the execute. You can see the CTs just counter smoking up
T-ramp?
No, yeah.
Oh, like the CTs.
When they come right here, where Debs is going to smoke.
Orange, I call it oranges, because yeah. they used to be oranges there.
Then they're going to throw a counter smoke, and it's going to be GG. But here comes the push with the CTs.
Actually, the smoke's quite late, too. The T's are able to push through, but they don't land many shots. Nafly will get a frag. And it's a five FAMASes on the CT side as well. Ooh, not bad by Nafly. Triple kill for him that round. It's an easy anti-eco on SKDC. I mean, they didn't really try anything different there, just threw a flash and just tried to push through the smoke and overpower them. But Denial have been landing their shots, and they've been on point this evening, the map four and so far on Inferno as well.
Exactly, and they're gonna go for another eco round, so it should be 3-0. And Shazam dropping a FAMAS to one of his teammates, just sticking with this CSID. So he's probably gonna go for the AWP in the next round.
Yes, I didn't buy any CZs the round before, though. They went for the P250s instead. It's an interesting choice on a force Spyron. I mean, you got armor, you might as well get the CZ. But they didn't get any frags the first round. Well, they got two, actually. But actually, why didn't they get CZs?
I think they had two CZs, maybe. The good thing is, if you only get 1,500 bucks, if you do it for the round loss, then you would go for P250 and flashbang instead of the CZ.
Absolute destruction here by Nitro. Quick triple triple kill with the FAMAS. And nice double kill earlier on by Nafly as well, as they completely stop that that eco round in its tracks. But SKDC now able to go for a full buy here on the fourth round. They didn't get any bomb plants, so they're forced to wait until the fourth round to go for a full buy.
And just same with the AWP. Surprise, surprise. I think he's peeking deep banana. Something seems like.
Really nice aggressive push here by the CTs on towards the banana. They get the map control to get the information, and they force the terrorists to kind of go towards the A site because they can't push up banana due to that smoke. But it's possible that you can do like a little boost here and get a frag if they want to, but automatic is just there getting the information and seeing how many CTs are remaining into banana. Because if there's only one CT, they can push it. They can flash it and go through, get that frag, and B site is completely open. But he sees two, and he's thinking, well, we should just wait.
Exactly.
There's also a mid smoke here from Shazam, and that's really going to slow things down for SKDC, but it's no problem as they're holding their positions, waiting to see just in case the CTs go for an aggressive push, which they won't be doing. And they have
Denial actually having extremely exposed positions here in middle. Normally, when you have that four-man stack towards A, you will play more passively, so you're not going to get caught by flashes and stuff. So they were actually really exposed. But let's see here, it's going to be the A push, and that's exactly what they want to to be having denial because the bait is real, but it's going to be the split B.
Oh, they see the split B and they are ready for them. Yes, they. Oh my lord, Dabs will get a double kill both on Slempy and ELS. Ocean will take him down though. Finally, he bunny hops away from one of the CTs as the bomb goes towards the B side here. Two in support, and there's only actually one. And this is not a very fast retake coming in from denial as well, as the terrorists are able to go for the bomb plant, automatic putting it down with protection from the smoke, and it's a 3-on-3 as the CTs go for the retake. Shazam will be smoked off here by the terrorists.
Yeah, he's gonna go for the CZ. He's gonna see Ocean here.
Ocean's gonna be ready for them here. Nice pop down. He gets the first, won't get the second. Shazam actually gets the better one with the CZ. He picks up the AK-47. Wabbit has to land his shot here. Fugly actually takes him down and takes Wabbit down. Huge throw there by Wabbit. He should have definitely landed that spray.
I'm not gonna say anything about it. That was kind of weird.
Also. Especially from a player who was performing so well the map before to flop an easy kill like that and allow his teammate to be killed by him as well. It was really Wabbit's fault in that situation.
Yeah, it was. Would he get that kill, he would be able to just play the time. So, set phase, move on. He's going to go for a nice play in some other round, I'm pretty sure. He's been showing great plays already.
They're trying to stop the CTs go for banana control by throwing those early flashes, but it's not allowed them to do that. As again, the CTs get banana control. They do have the information. They're not going towards the B site, and then they can have a four-man stack on towards the A site, leave one man on the B site, just like they did the round before. And it worked out pretty well for them, except for the fact that Ocean was able to kind of get away with the B split through Arch. But it's an A push here coming in from the terrorist. Shazam able to get one frag on Wabbit. They push through. Good counter flash coming in from the CTs, but actually there's a flash as well from the terrorist, forcing him to back away, so he's not able to capitalize on his flash on Arch side. And the terrorists are still alive here. Shazam will land the shot on ELS. Two frags for him so far. He's done a great job defending the A side from Arch side. The terrorists have decided to come in from a different position, but Shazam's ready, and he lands a shot, makes it 3K. He's done his job. It doesn't matter if he's dead now. It's a 3-on-2 situation, however, as the remaining CT players have not done much this round. Bomb will be planted by Slempy. 2 against 3. Slempy and Automatic are not in the best positions, and Denial should just wait for them to kind of peek out. They can't hide for long. Will be able to get a nice crossfire. Fugly with a double kill, taking out both Slempy and Automatic, making it 5-0 as Denial are continuing a very, very dominant streak against SKDC.
Yes. 5-0, great play by Shazam. They're getting a triple. He's maybe a bit greedy going for the fourth one that early, but you know, you gotta go for the frag clips sometimes.
Yeah, frag clips. And Tweeday.
Yeah, well, I know it myself. Sometimes you just get the feeling that you can destroy everybody, even if you're in a kind of terrible position for going, for the re-peak. But he goes for it. He's gonna miss it, but Fugly in the pit playing it for perfection.
Yeah, making sure they don't lose that round. But it was Shazam's round. Wabbit with an entry frag on towards the B side, taking out Daps as that aggressive push coming in from the CTs did not work out for them. They weren't flashed properly. But they do get the smoke down regardless, and they do have banana control, the CTs, once more. Again, every round with the banana control, the terrorists have to kind of counteract that. And how can they counteract that, Kadian?
There's several ways of doing it. One of them is just wait out the time, go off for B. You'll still have around 30 seconds to work with. You can see he's going to throw his smoke here at 1 minute. That is going to be away at around, I don't know, 40.
Yep.
A smoke lasts for 16-17 seconds. So they will actually still have a lot of time to work with. So instead of initiating a direct push into middle, you can take control over middle and then move back to banana. Just make sure that you gain map control over other parts of the map. So I'm actually a bit sad to see them not going for apps control or anything, because theoretically, the CTs could have a lot of information about what the terrorist is doing, because they're just moving as one unit all the time. And that is going to destroy a lot of their map control.
They've gone through that smoke, they've given away the position, the CTs know they're going towards the B side. This would be a perfect time to go for a fake, because, I mean, the CTs have no idea. Shazam landing a shot just before the smoke appeared, and he'll make it a 4-on-3 situation as the terrorists push into the site, and the CTs are waiting for the main. SKDC's terrorist side has been really, really lackluster. 10 seconds left on the clock, the bomb's down. Doesn't seem likely they'll be able to win this round here. They can get, perhaps, another frag ELS. But 2 seconds, 1 second, and there you go. Denial with 6 rounds so far on this map, and SKDC on the T side, they're just really, really, really suffering.
He dies after time. 600 bucks in the
zero
bank.
Money and no gun.
Yips. Good luck, have fun, bro.
That's a horrible position to be in, but they're unable to go for a buy regardless.
Yeah, but still, in the next round, he's probably still going to have to go for a pistol or something.
Yeah.
Kind of sad. 6-0, and Denial looking pretty goddamn pure.
Yeah, again, they go for the banana control, they throw down that smoke, they go for the spray down. Oh, Daps actually lands a shot. And right through that smoke, lucky shot, and unlucky for SKDC. They've already lost a man, but they've not done anything fast. They've not gone for a fast A push. They've not really gone for Apps control, even though ELS is there right now. And it's just too easy. Shazam with a triple kill.
Thank you, auto director. Thank you, auto director, for only giving us that last kill. But you asked me what is the solutions for the banana control, and you kind of answered that with the last phrase, which is the fast A push. Because if you know they're gonna go three guys down banana.
Oh yeah, of course.
That's why you can go up directly for A while there are only two guys.
They've done it every round. Yeah. Every round they've gone for a banana, banana control with three men. Mm-hmm. They know that. They've seen that. Mm-hmm. So why not go for a fast A? You know, there's only two people on the A side. SKDC right now are just showing that strategically they're just not on the same level as Denial.
Exactly, because when things start to get very serious is when the CT starts to take banana control with only two guys, letting three guys be in the A-bomb side, or even fake it. But so far they haven't done that. So unless Denial starts faking, it's just really not the other team adapting, and he's going to go for the JW. You're going to get the second kill with the CZ.
You can't push a you can't push a position where you know the player is on form. You know Shazam is landing his shots, and he's getting those kills, and he's been doing that for the first few rounds. He's on 15 kills and 2 deaths. Why go to Arch again? You're going to Arch again and again and again, trying to take down Shazam, and he's doing an excellent job. 2K there, that's his job done. He doesn't need to do any more than
that. I actually think that the CTs smoked a deep banana in that situation, didn't go for the control though, so I actually think that they were trying to counter that with going for the fast mid push. It seemed like it. It really seemed like it, but I'm not sure. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm right.
But it wasn't fast enough.
Yeah, and look, this Apps push by the CT is changing up the game style, going for map control in a different place than Banana this time, so... Yeah.
Well, they've given away Banana, but they've taken Apps. And we've got Fugly here, with support from Nitro over on Apartments. Wabbit will actually take down Shazam, and a Molotov in it forces him out, but he will get the kill on ELS. He should have been ready for him. He knew his teammate threw down that Molotov, so he should have gotten that kill, but ELS, far too slow. He'll be shot down there by Nitro, and he's actually survived that encounter. Burning, fiery encounter over in Apartments.
Yeah.
4-on-4, as Shazam was shot down earlier on by Wabbit. He doesn't have a lot of HP, Wabbit, however, and they're going to push towards the A site. There's only two. One of the CTs quite deep. At archway.
Yeah, he has fast rotation to B, but he's still going to be able to tell his teammates if they're going to wrap around from arch. So that is a very clever position and a nice grenade by Nitro. And here comes the triple arch push, and Nafly is going to get the first, and this guy could be caught. That is Nitro. Slippery communication, I think.
Wabbit with a really nasty
Look, this position by Daps. He's going all in with this position. It's do or die.
Oh, he's going to get it. Wabbit has no idea. He gets the first frag. He'll get the second. Beautiful positioning there by Daps. Exactly when the CT side needed. Had he lost that, they would have gotten the bomb plant and might have won the round because it was a 2-on-1. But really, really well done by Daps. And it was a clever idea from SKDC. They just had to check the corners.
Exactly. You talked about it earlier, going for the unexpected moves. That was an unexpected move. They would expect him to be in the bump side somewhere, just hiding in a corner up there, try to pull the time, but he decided to go for that one. That was very clever play by him.
A deep smoke, they don't have an op, they know Shazam's with the op down there. Actually, they had double op, but for some reason...
No, actually he had time to swap it out in the end depths.
Oh,
yeah, he was like messing around with that E, just trying to get away the op because his teammate already picked one up.
Yeah.
And they have loads of money. Shazam is going to get all the map control in the world. So look at the rotation coming in for the guys now. They're going to go directly towards this B bump side.
And there's a smoke down as well.
Why don't they move towards B faster?
Well, if they're going to push through the smoke, they're really, really, really going to suffer. Nafly will get a frag through the smoke on. And the smoke gets renewed as well. Should be easy kills here for Denial. Plus, you have CTs coming up for support. Well, Terrace are in the site. Daps is still alive. That smoke gives them enough coverage to stay alive. The bomb gets planted at least by SKDC, but another kill through the smoke by Daps will make it a 2-on-5 situation. Almost unwinnable odds here for the terrorist side, who so far have really, really provided absolutely nothing.
Yeah, it's going to be 10-0 going double digits now. And it was actually kind of weird because we saw Shazam pushing out in the apps. He cleared out the whole middle and second mid area. And still no one of the Denial A players decided to rotate towards B, so it could actually have been a good move by SKDC. but the counter smokes by denial was simply just too strong, and we all know how annoying it can be to run through these smokes.
Yep. So yeah. Especially when there's a CT peeking and a CT who's landing a shot deep smoke now. Wabbit's actually able to go through.
Well, they surely pushed this time. Do they expect him here? Oh, the
double nade right on top of his head. They knew exactly where he was. Beautiful play by Denial. Great teamwork, and they just seem like a more cohesive team right now. They seem like they're really on point. They are playing as a team. They're playing with some nice tactics. Beautiful Molotov down mid over towards the T ramp as well, and it forces Automatic to follow. And they've cut them up in half. Literally, they've cut up the team in half. The terrorists are forced to kind of push towards mid, since they're being herded from Banana as well. Shazam ready for them with the AWP there on our side, however, and Nafly with that Banana control. Denial so far playing some pretty good textbook CT play, indeed.
Exactly.
Goes to watch outside. Shazam checking left. He should just keep on our side. I mean, he has two players over on Truck's side, so you should just give them the benefit of the doubt. ELS with a really cheeky kill. Automatic takes down Daps on the other side. This could be a good start here for the Terrorists, but Fugly and Nafly return in the favor. Very quickly, two kills coming in, and a third quick double kill from both players as they retake the site. Well, not really retake the site, but come up from behind over while they were in Truck side before they could really do more damage and make it 11-0 for Denial.
They are playing very slow with these pushes, SKDC. You could see them getting very nice entry kills there, but the fact that they were so slow made the CT rotation being simply too fast. And they were just getting, pushed in the bats.
I think it's going to be an early night here for SKDC. 11 rounds, now probably 12.
Ooh, Nitro with one, with two. No, he's not going to get much more from that.
Only one kill, actually. Disastrous spray down from Nitro. Had he not thought he could have landed those shots, he should have just backed away, but only 20 bullets, and this is a pretty good eco round from the Terrorists, as they've for once gone for a really fast A push, and it's worked out for them.
Yeah. Even though it was kind of individual mistakes by the CT side, you still have to give them credit for just finally going for a YOLO push.
Yeah, YOLO.
YOLO, and it worked out perfectly. And here comes the retake by Nafly and Debs. Are they going to be able to do this? Debs in a 1-on-3 is going to get the first for sure. Oh, a stupid peek coming in for motion, and this is going to be a 1-on-3 here.
What a beautiful shot there by Daps.
He's going out of the defuse. He had it.
Oh, and he's going to pull out. He actually throws away that round. It will be a defuse coming in for their CTs, and that makes it 12-0. Unbelievable here, as SKDC, they had that round in the bag. It was an eco round, of course, but still, you had three men against one. But Daps rising up to the occasion, 14.8k in his bank as he gets that triple kill at the end. But really, really nice of them, and really nice reactions as well.
That was crazy.
Why peek?
Yeah, why? That guy jumping up in the car, he was the black goat of the family. He was the nemesis of his own team.
Could have been one round for SKDC. And we've seen it on Inferno. We've seen Terrorist side lose the first 10 rounds and come back with actually 4 or 5 rounds before the start of the second half. And then it becomes pretty manageable, starting off on the CT side with 5 or 4 rounds. At least, if you lose the pistol round, you're not out of the game straight away. Denial now. Shazam going back to Arch.
Exactly. Shazam is going to smoke up the middle. Are they going to push through it this time?
He's been doing the same play every single round, and it's really working out for him. Smokes down mid. Even if he gets smoked off, he just changes position and lands the shots regardless. But we do have some apartment control coming in from the Terrorists for once, and Automatic actually...
Oh, they're boosting.
Yeah, they're doing the boost, finally. Yeah. And that's another way, I think, to counter that deep smoke. It's going for the boost and getting that frag. But late smoke from Nav.
Go through the smoke. Get the control, my friend. No, they're not going to do it.
They just lack the confidence at the moment.
Yeah, they do. They really don't feel
that they can do it. They're going to push towards the A site. There is a rotation from one of the CTs towards the B site, so there's only going to be three men here. It could have been four. Would have been worse. Shazam will go down, and Fugly will finish off ELS. I think it took too long to take down Shazam, but it's a 3-on-2 situation here. The Terrorists are still going towards the A site. It's one
sneaky play by Fugly. They're not going to expect this. He's going to get the first. He's going to reposition himself in the side. Turn around, my friend. He's going to go for the second one. Is he going to get him? He's going to get him to low HP.
Absolutely beautiful by Fugly.
And is he going to lock down this bump side entirely by himself? Time is running out.
Oh, too easy for Fugly.
4k by him. I don't know. They have been in good positions to actually get, I don't know, four rounds. But they're just too slippery when it comes to actually ending the rounds. Their decision making is quite questionable.
I think SKDC right now have just lost the momentum that they had in the first game, and they've just lost the confidence, and I think
have been really, really hurt by, you know, the good performance of Denial. And I think right now they're just looking at Denial, and it, to them, it's just an invulnerable wall that they cannot cross. They can't climb it. They can't blow through it. They've tried everything in the book, and it's just not worked out for them. And in the last seconds of every single round, they've been let down by some really, really nice solo play coming in from the Denial players. And it must be very difficult. It must be very, very difficult for them to kind of do that. And 13 rounds given away. SKDC, they've pretty much given up, I think. I mean, it's very difficult, even if they get two rounds, now.
Just to make everything clear, SKDC was leading 13-6 in the previous map. So imagine how many rounds they have lost out of the last 20 rounds. It's like, or 30 rounds. It's just
every
crazy.
Round. Yeah. They've lost every round.
Maybe got one or something on catch, I don't know.
No, they're 13.
It was 13. Yep. Okay, so they lost what? 25 rounds in a row or something.
Yep.
That's quite a streak to go through in a semifinal.
Really, really dominant performance coming in from Denial. And the second.
Oh, Webbit is going to get his second kill. This orb is finally paying off.
He's been landing some shots, really, in some of the rounds. But it's not the same Webbit that we saw in the first map on Cash. And they are finally able to get control of the A site with the bomb plant and having four men as well against the two players in Daps and Nafly. But we've seen Daps and Nafly win 1v3s. They've won the clutches. And there, poor start here. As they try to defend the site, Nafly were able to get a frag on Webbit, technically, so far, the strongest player on their T side. Crossfire coming in from the CTs. They don't have a lot of time. ELS will be able to take down Nafly. It should be a round for SKDC as they get one consolation round, but I don't think it's going to be enough to kind of continue their adventures in the John Wick Invitational.
So they get the first round, finally, due to the entry kills of Webbit. And he's going to have the ult once again. Let's see if Shazam is going to go for the mid peak one more time. He could probably go for it. This time he's probably going to use a flash or something else. Actually, Ocean is going to smoke off the middle area, so Webbit is going to have to wait with working on the middle area. He's probably going to go for Banana or something like that.
It's a very fast speed push coming in from the Ferris. That smoke kind of cut him off a bit, but they're going to continue pushing in. I think perhaps they should just try and go for the fast speed push. There's only two CTs and no smoke down at the moment. They might be able to get control, but the smoke will come after they threw that Molotov. And that CT smoke is going to be for waste unless they decide to push through that smoke that the CT's through.
Yeah. The thing is, the terrorist is too scared of just going before the smoke pops. You should go for the instant smoke. Every time they decide to smoke CT, it's above the wall, which gives the counter-terrorist about 5 seconds to take out the smoke grenade and counter-smoke, or reposition themselves in a position where they're not going to get caught. So when you want to do it, you go up, you clear the close bus, such as behind the car and sandbags, you throw an instant smoke onto CT and you just start the running train. But once again, they're so slow on this push that the Denial team is going to be three guys towards this side.
Yeah, they checked mid, they knew they weren't pushing up mid. Didn't hear anything in apartment. Shazam with two kills before being shot down finally by Automatic. And Terrace are all over the place here. Nitro cleaning up the little mess that they have on towards the B site. And it's just really, really, really dominating performances here from Denial, making it 14-1. It should be an alien out here for SKDC, especially if they lose the pistol round. But, I mean, we've seen incredible comebacks on Inferno before. We've seen teams come back from really crazy odds and just playing a really, really solid CT side. But is SKDC the team that is capable of doing that? And do they have the quality? And I mean, it's not really a problem of quality. I think at the moment it's just a problem of form. And
yeah.
The players.
But they had a good CT side last game, so.
Good, but not good enough to get 15 rounds in a row.
Yeah. And let's see, who's just going to come in? Awful positions because they're going to be isolated one by one. Ocean hiding here. Nitro doesn't see him. Nice.
The thing is, Ocean had a smoke. He could have thrown down a smoke over on towards Banana and slowed down that push, but he decided not to. And now they've done the CT smoke, so they're either going to push through the smoke or come in from the position that they know they're going to come in. They've got two CTs over on Banana, but it's a retake, and there's not a lot of time left on the clock. Three armor on the T side with only two, but they do have a defuse kit on the CT side. Shazam will take down ELS with relative ease. Some nice clockwork.
He's going for the defuse!
They've gone for the ninja defuse. Will he have enough time? He is going to survive just for a moment, but I think he's dead. Ocean's the remaining player here. They go for the knife. It's 15-1. They try to remove the remaining kind of honor and respect.
Yeah.
live in front of the audience, but at least Ocean came out of that with a bullet through his chest rather than a knife through his heart.
Exactly. That goes if he kind of gave us a small lag in the ninja defuse. For a second, I was worried that he was actually going to get it. I like the fact that they just went for some YOLO play because they were definitely not in the position to go for that retake.
It could have worked. It could have worked because it was one defuse kit. They might as well use it, and they know that it's going to be very difficult for them to get the retake. It's pretty short distance against the Glocks, and you know, in that kind of situation, the Glocks do have a bit of the advantage. But 15-1 here.
And we get a small question we can quickly answer in the chat, which is, when is the finals going to be in? They're going to be tomorrow. The second semi-final is going to be after this one, and then the final is going to be tomorrow, so...
Yep, same. At 2:30, I think, or 2 o'clock. But you guys check the FACEIT website or check HLTV for more information on that here. Denial actually really badly hurt, but they've gone two frags.
Is that impossible for the CT side to turn this around? They just need one guy sitting up, and that's the first kill.
Yeah, it'll be pretty much... Delaying the inevitable.
I was just going to say second that phrase. But
I mean, there's not much in this kind of situation that you can do 15-1.
Yeah,
it's very, very, very difficult. It seems like Denial will be securing their place as one of the finalists of the John Wick Invitational. Ocean is the remaining player here for the CTs, and there you go. 16-1. Very, very dominant performance here from Denial as they... pretty much won a match where we assumed that they'd win, and they won a match where we expected perhaps a bit stronger performance from SKDC, especially after that cash.
Yeah.
Nice CT side on cash. We expected perhaps a stronger side on Inferno, but they started off on the T side, they started off on the weaker side, and you know, losing so many rounds on the T side, it just took away all the momentum, it took away all the confidence that they had.
Well, yeah, they lost the momentum on catch, and then a kind of awful T pistol round going through that smoke is just demolishing for your morale, and after that they had quite a lot of questionable decisions by not even trying to contest the banana control from the Denial side. Mm. Not only that, they actually went for the A push nearly 9 out of 10 times when they had the banana control Denial. So that means that they're actually going to go exactly for what Denial wants to, which is the A push where they're going to be stacked up four guys.
But they can pat themselves on the back. I mean, they beat Elevate. Mm-hmm. They came to the semifinals and they went home with $2,400.
Yeah, they did good on CT catch as well.
$2,500, sorry. And they did well on cash. Yeah. Wabbit performed incredibly well, and I'm sure there's going to be some content for those frag clip makers out there, especially with some of the stuff that Wabbit did. Nitro actually did really well as well, and Shazam played quite great. And Daps actually had a really nice 3K on Inferno. Regardless, it was a bit of a shoveling. I think they were digging their graves. And,
for sure.
It was a really, really dominating performance by Denial. But we will have the second match of this evening starting pretty soon. But until then, we'll have a short break and we'll be right back. While we have this break, you guys can follow us on Twitter and send us some of your messages at CasperKadian.
Yeah. Tell us who you think is going to win. And if you have any special information about the American players, try and hook us up. We're not experts yet, hopefully after the game.
Yes, and you can also check out the John Wick's trailer as well. I think it'll be playing during the break. But we'll see you guys in a moment. And by the way, for those who just joined us, we mentioned it earlier, John Wick's will be released tomorrow to send in cinemas. It's a pretty interesting movie with one of my favorite actors, Keanu Reeves, about a guy who decides to go on a rampage because somebody killed his puppy, which was given to him by his girlfriend.
Yeah, which was ill or something, died by something, right?
His girlfriend, yes. Yeah. His girlfriend died, the puppy remained, and then the puppy died, or was killed.
The puppy was kind of the symbol, so to say, for his wife or something.
Oh, some movie analysis already. I mean, the movie's not
out. The last memory, you know?
The movie's not out, and he's already analyzing the movie. Standard Cadian. He's a great CSGO analyzer, and he's also a movie analyzer now, so that's interesting. But we'll be right back after the short break. Don't go anywhere.